Here we go. We have the first Twiso pairs lining up at the start line. It's going to be two pairs run at one time, just to be more efficient with the track. This being a full size racetrack, it's a bit more difficult to go from the finish line to the start line. So the format will be running pair number one for the first lap. Then we're going to be running pair number two for the first lap. Then the pair number one for the second lap, and a pair number two for the second lap. Judges will be giving advantage to one driver or the other, the best driver after one run, and after the two runs they will decide the winner, or if is the case, one more time. Our three judges today here on the judging tower. It's Mantas, the organizer of Eastern European Drift Championship, Max Miller from Ukraine, and Ishvan from the Hungarian side. There will be no warm-up laps for the top 16 at all, so the guys will go straight into the battle. Looks like we are ready for the first pair. They're going straight for the first run, no warm-up run on this top 16. Dima Nagula from Belarus in the Nissan S13, and Jugovic Ishvan in the Red Suns Nissan S14. Dima Nagula being the top qualifier, he will lead this battle, the first run of this battle. Here we go, first run from our Twiso battles today. Dima Nagula in front, Jugovic Ishvan chasing, crazy entry from Dima Nagula like we see in qualification. Huge amount of smoke. Red Suns S14 goes washed out a little bit on the first corner, and he's struggling to keep up with Dima. Looks like he went straight on the last section of the track, so he'll be at disadvantage for this run. This is actually quite evenly matched cars. Here comes out of the chicane the V12 Mercedes, close followed by the V8 of Hüther Ferenc for Sierra. Very close proximity in the first corner. Good run so far from both drivers. Hüther Ferenc is actually managing to keep the proximity in the first corner. By then he cheated the line a little bit on the last corner. We'll see how judges will judge this. Probably a little bit of disadvantage for the chase car. Advantage for the V12 Mercedes of Amon Oliver, from what the judge says. Better line, especially on the outside zones. Hüther Ferenc managed to keep proximity really nice on the first corner, but then on the second part of the track he went offline, went a little bit on the east side and lost a little bit of speed, being left behind a little bit. Here they go, finding their way back to the start line. Very hot today at Hungaroring. Everybody must stay hydrated, this crazy heat. It's quite humid. Here we go. S14 leading the S13 of Dima Nagula in the first corner. Good initiation at front, good initiation at the back. Good chase run by Dima Nagula, closing in on the S14. Good run from both guys. Let's see what the judges say. Dima had a huge advantage from the first run, so let's see what the judges decide. All three judges decided Dima Nagula in his S13 from Belarus, he's winning this, he's the winner of this battle. So Dima Nagula gets the win.
So the winner is Dima Nagula. The next pair is Hutefelin, Oliver Amon.
Here we go, Hutefelin, Oliver Amon into the first corner. A bit of separation between the two cars. Good line up front, putting a wheel off on the second outside zone. Mercedes didn't manage to close the gap, keep pretty much the same proximity from the start to the finish of this this lap. Let's see what the judge says. Amon Oliver had a little bit of advantage from his first run. Like I said at the beginning, these two cars are actually quite evenly matched in power and setup, and there you have it, they're going at it again. So you're going to see Amon Oliver with the V12 Mercedes and Hutefelin in the Ford Sierra in a one more time battle shortly. Now, Starline, Szabó Szilárd, qualifying number 4 with Drift Monkey S15 versus Radi János, qualifying 13 with the R33 Skyline. Fast entry from Szilárd, as we've seen with him during qualification as well. Nice line, stayed on the throttle. Skyline is nowhere close to him. Szabó Szilárd misses completely the last outside zone. Let's see what the judges decide. Radir didn't manage to close the gap with the car in front. Szabó Szilárd had a fantastic initiation, very good first corner, a good first outside zone, but then he missed the second outside zone. Radir didn't manage to close the gap at all, so let's see what the judges deliberate. A small advantage for the Drift Monkey S15, Szabó Szilárd. He had a better run in the first sector of the track. He only just missed the last clipping zone, comparing with Radir, which didn't have the line angle and also didn't measure the speed. Here we go, Ladi Attila versus Tomas Batory. Ladi Attila in the Drift Monkey Supra at front. Good initiation, Tomas Batory, good proximity, right behind him. Small correction from Batory while chasing. Both cars hitting the outside, the first outside zone. I think Ladi Attila just missed a little bit the second outside zone. Good overall run by both cars. Huge amounts of smoke from the Drift Monkey Supra. Judges are watching the live stream replay at the moment, just to see if they haven't missed anything. Check all the angles from all the cameras as well. It's difficult to see the last section of the track because of the huge amounts of smoke these cars are generating. Here we go, off the line, Radir just coming out of the chicane, S15 close by. Good initiation by the Skyline. And Szilárd spins out behind. I'm not sure exactly what happened there, but I think the Skyline did a mistake as well. After the initiation, he braked too much, which actually caused Szilárd to spin, but we're waiting from judges to give us confirmation on what developed.
Thank you.
szóval nagy tengedélyre várunk.
So looks like we're going for the one more time battle between Szoboszlád and Radir in the skyline. Nice initiation by both guys in the first corner. Full speed for Szoboszlád the front. The skyline is having a clean run behind but didn't manage to close the proximity. This was a good run for both drivers. The chase car didn't manage to put any pressure or attack the car in front. Let's see what the judges decide.
Szoboszlárdot és Rodák János ugye másodtól láthatjuk, ez egy újrahívás, most helyet fognak cserélni, és a fordított felállásba is meg fogják ismételni a csaták.
Judges are confirming that both car have nice and clean runs, but the S15, Drift Monkey S15, Szoboszlád gets a slight advantage because of the gap he managed to pull on the chase car. Second half of the battle between Ladi Attila and the Drift Monkey Supra and Tomas Batory on the E46 BMW from Slovakia.
Kicsit nehezebb követni, viszont a pálya adottságai tekintve messze van a rajt a céltól, ezért minden versenyzőt vissza kell küldeni.
This time Tomas Batory is the lead car and Lati Adilo in the Supra is chase car. Here they come off the line into the first corner. Good initiation by both cars. Looks like both cars struggle for grip in the first corner. Supra closed the gap, but then in the final clipping zone, they both missed the clipping zone. And from what I can see, Supra had a quite big correction on the last on the apex of the last corner. We have the second half of the battle from Szoboszlád, the Drift Monkey S15 versus Radir in the R33 GTST Skyline. Here they come off the line from the chicane. Radir is leading, Szilard is chasing, huge entry from the Skyline, small correction at the entry, huge correction in the middle of the corner, he almost goes straight. Both are going outside to the first outside zone. Still goes a bit wide on the last corner, but he touches the second outside zone as well. Let's see what the judges are gonna decide. From what I can see, the lead car had major corrections on the entry on the first corner, so let's see what the judges say. Here they come out the chicane, struggling for grip. Gosling initiated high speed, good angle, good line to the first corner, working the clutch to get the revs correctly. I think he's a bit shy of the second outside zone, but a strong lead car. Unfortunately for the chase car, he didn't manage to stay close to Grossinger. Also, he didn't manage to match his angle and line for this first run. Looks like one of the cars lost one of the GoPros from the car, so the marshals just cleaning the track and recovering what's left of the camera. Looks like it's in many bits.
Ismo Tenila is out.
Szóval, Román Koleszár.
Here we go, out of the chicane, Román Koleszár leading his teammate. Carlo. Good line in front, keeping very good throttle control, staying on the perfect line, good speed as well, touching the first outside zone, missing a little bit on the second outside zone, but pulling a huge gap from the chase car.
Szóval, hölgyeim és uraim, ez volt a top 16-nak az utolsó csatája, de van még egy visszahívásunk, amit hamarosan láthattok. Szóval ez volt az utolsó pár, a top 16-ból őket fogjuk látni még fordított felállásban, és van még egy visszahívásunk.
Golyónál állunk ismét. This was a really, really strong lead run from Roman Kolesár. He left his teammate in the some Zestino tire smoke. He pulled a huge gap on the chase car. He stayed a huge angle, good initiation in on the correct line. Just a bit shy of the second outside zone, but overall a strong lead run. It's a little bit of a hold up as one of the drivers is having an inquiry about his run. We're talking about Ladi Attila in the Drift Monkey Supra. He basically just was having a chat with the judges about his runs. Here we go. S15 leading in the first corner. He's quite slow for Grossinger as we suspected. Grossinger adjusts with huge angle. Good line as well. Working the clutch for in order to keep good proximity. It wasn't the best lead run, so it was probably a bit difficult for the chase cars to follow, but I think Rosiger did a decent job adjusting his car to the car in front. Let's see what the judges says. I suspect Rosiger will get the win. And yes, it's confirmed, Grossinger Zsolt gets the win. From after the first half of the battle, Roman Kolesár has a clear advantage with a solid lead car, lead run. Let's see, here they come out of the chicane. Good speed, good initiation in the front, really good initiation in the front. Kolesár is chasing, he's not closing the gap too well. The car in front had a correction on the first outside zone. Kolesár had a pretty clean run behind on the chase position. He didn't put a lot of pressure on the car in front, but a pretty clean run from him. Judges are reviewing the run now on the replay to look for obvious mistakes, and they will give the verdict. Now we should be revisiting the battle between Amon Oliver, number 8 qualified, and Hüther Ferenc, number 9 qualified.
So it comes Attila Nitrai alone again, because his spell is not Attila is out of
range. Oh, and before that we have another situation where our pilot gets automatically a bye to the top 8. Ismo Tenila blow up his engine in the JZX90, and Nitros Attila is doing just a demo run. He's automatically into the top 8. Okay, here we go. Amon Oliver leading Hüther Ferenc. Amon Oliver in front in the V12 Mercedes, and Hüther Ferenc in chase position in the V8 Ford Sierra. Here they come out of the chicane to the first corner. Good initiation by both drivers. Good proximity, pretty clean battle so far. Good transition. It seems like Hüther Ferenc in the chase position with the Ford Sierra lost a little bit of proximity on the second half of the track. Let's see what the judges gonna decide. Here we go, out of the chicane, on the main straight, down the hill. Getting as much speed as they can to that first corner. Good initiation, especially at the rear. Sierra gets completely washed out of the track. Mercedes is adjusting and keeping, staying in drift while adjusting for the Sierra. I think this is going to be a 10-0.
Lithuania, ők hárman, a magyar ötös ellen. So we have three drivers in the top eight from international competitors, and we have five Hungarian in the top eight.
So in the top eight, we have Dima Nagula from Belarus. We have Tomas Batory from Slovakia. We have Roman Kolesar from Slovakia, and they're all international drivers fighting. Amon Oliver from Hungary, Szabó Szilárd from Hungary, Grazinger Zsolt from Hungary, and Nitrai Nitros Attila from Hungary. So it's actually pretty evenly split field here of international and local drivers. So let's see how this is going to go down. Szabó Szilárd leading as a higher qualifier. Here we go, out of the chicane and on the main straight, getting as much speed to the first corner. As suspected, Szabó Szilárd is a lot faster. Very good line to the first corner for both drivers, but Szilárd is just gone. His car is really, really fast. He missed the second outside zone, so let's see how the judge is going to interpret that. Okay, looks like they're ready at the start line. Here we go for the second half of the battle. Tomas Batory leading. I think Szilárd is giving him a little bit of the gap. Initially in the first corner. S15 already catching up. I can see a little bit of left foot braking from the chase car as well. He doesn't have so much proximity as he should. Let's see what the judge is gonna say. I also see quite a big correction on the last corner from the chase car. Basically in these three locations there's the Hungarian National Drift Championship, EDC Championship and City Drift Challenge. Here we go, Nitrai Attila leading Roman Kolesar. Huge initiation from the S14, small correction. Zestino Tires BMW staying quite close to the S14. Good run in front, good lead run, good chase run. Was actually a not bad chase run from Kolesar. He managed to put a little bit of pressure. Good lead run as well. Good initiation from the S14. Let's see what the judge is going to say about this. So basically during a season between Slovakia and Hungary, you can see the national championship, the Hungarian National Drift Championship. You can see two rounds of the Eastern European Drift Championship at Robertsring track with the Trackwood Festival and at the Hungaroring. Then you can see City Drift Challenge, which is held at Slovakia Ring as well. Judges confirm Kolesar put a solid chase run behind the S14, so he's having a little bit of advantage. Swapping around the positions, now we're going to have Zestino Tires, BMW E46 leading the Red Suns, S14 Silvia, Roman Kolesar versus Nitros Attila. Here they come, out of the chicane. Good initiation for both guys. Roman manages to put the power down a little bit better, getting a little bit of advantage. And he managed to pull a gap on the S14. So I think this was a solid lead run by Kolesar as suspected. His car has the ability even downhill to put the power down a little bit more efficient. So he managed to pull a gap on the first half of the track and then kept that gap to the rest of the track until the finish line. No major mistakes by both guys, but I think Kolesar was a little bit more dominant on his chase and on his lead car. Let's see what the judges have to say about this. At the start line, Grazinger Zsolt versus Nagyházi Lawrence. Grazinger Zsolt has the highest qualification score, and he will be leading this first lap of this battle. There we go, off the chicane. Right behind him. Good initiation. Nadhazi staying close. Getting. Nadhazi runs wide. Now he's going to get blinded by the smoke, going straight. Clear domination from Grozinger Zsolt as expected. And Nadhazi Lawrence goes straight again on the last corner. So I would imagine this will be a huge advantage for the lead car. It's very difficult in the chase position if you're not able to stay on the correct line behind the lead car. It's very easy to get blinded by the huge amount of smoke, and then obviously you're more likely to do mistakes. Here we go, off the line, very fast off the line, Nadhazi Lawrence. Big gap between them. Let's see if Grozinger. And the judges are giving the yellow flag. This will be a rerun. Nadhazi Lawrence leading Grozinger Zsolt. They repeat this run. Good pullout from both cars off the line. Still a little bit of the gap. So obviously the leading S30 has a little bit more grip off the line. Huge angle in the first corner by Grozinger Zsolt. I'm not sure if he manages to went, to go wide to the first clipping zone. Let's see what the judges are going to decide on this instance.
Szóval, hölgyeim és uraim, mindjárt megszületik a döntés. Természetesen az első kör miatt Grozinger Zsoltnál van az előny.
Not the best chase run, but also not, I mean, not the best lead run, but not the best chase run as well. Let's see what the judge is going to say. Lead run was a bit shallow angle, not a perfect line on the first corner, pretty good on the second half of the track with the clipping zones. Grozinger Zsolt chased pretty good on the first corner, but then he wound up a little bit more angle than he should have, missed the outside, the first outside zone. Okay on the second outside zone, but he had a huge advantage from his first run. Here we go. Szabó Szilárd in the Drift Monkey S15 leading from Tomasz Bátori in the E46 BMW from Slovakia. The S15 is fast. Huge initiation from the S15 in front. Automatically generating some gap. Good line for both cars. Perfect on the outside zone. Good flick. And it looks like the E46 missed the drift. On the last corner, so probably there's going to be a zero for him. So huge advantage to Szabó Szilárd. Perfect run in front, a bit shy of the last outside zone, but other than that, pretty solid run from Drift Monkey S15.
It's done.
It's running now.
For who?
Szóval, hölgyeim és uraim, küldjük is vissza az autókat a rajtba.
Okay, here we go, the second half of this battle. This time Tomasz Bátori is leading the Drift Monkey S15 out of the chicane, struggling for grip down the hill, getting maximum speed. good initiation at the front. Savo Szilárd giving him a little bit of a gap, but then chasing hard. It's so much smoke on the track, basically not able to see the half second half of the track, but solid lead run, nothing to lose for Thomas Battery. Let's see on the replay cams what happened on the chase run. Savo Szilárd was carrying a huge advantage from his first run. Let's see what happened on this run. Let's get confirmation from the judges. On the start line we have Dima Nagula from Belarus versus Amon Oliver in the V12 Mercedes. Dima Nagula was our top qualifier today. It's gonna be a tough battle for the Mercedes. Dima Nagula is going to be leading the first lap of the battle, being the highest qualifier, and Amon Oliver on his V12 Mercedes is going to be giving chase.
Ready. Sunglasses. I have some sunglasses.
I can not afford.
Here we go, out of the chicane, Dima Nagula up front, good initiation, front and back, actually Mercedes initiation earlier, a lot more speed carried to the first corner by Dima Nagula, big gap developing between the two cars. Ayrton Senna corners at Hungaroring F1 track, being completely smoked out by this S13 from Belarus. Very solid run from Dima Nagula. You can clearly see the big advantage in the two vehicles and also driving skills. So Amon Oliver did the best he could to keep up, but just wasn't up for the job. So Dima Nagula, I'm pretty sure, has a huge advantage after this first solid lead run. Ready to go out of the chicane. Dima Nagula chasing close into the first corner. Huge initiation from the Mercedes way earlier than the S13. Very good proximity from Dima Nagula. Huge proximity. Mercedes went straight off the track. Dima Nagula overtook on the outside and carry on with his drifting. What a crazy run. Now the judges must make sure they check for contact or other things which could have happened on the screen of smoke, and then they gotta give us the confirmation of who's the winner of this battle. Great battle. Amon Oliver did best to go to run away, but the S13 from Belarus is a very fast car. He been scoring the best and the fastest speeds, entry speeds all day.
Dima Nagula, így Amon Oliver a top 8-nál esett ki, nem jutott tovább a top 4-be. Nagyon ügyes volt, felvette a kesztyűt. Nem ismétlem magamat, nem úgy, mint néhány versenyző, aki itt ül a lelátón. Szóval, hölgyeim és uraim, el is érkeztünk a top 4-hez. És a párosítás. Dima Nagula versus Savo Szilárd. Szóval, hölgyeim és uraim,
this battle is going to be intense. These two guys can definitely smoke this place out. Huge amount of smoke coming from both cars. Közinger Zsolt running Achilles tires. Roman Kolesár on the BMW running Zestino tires.
35 fok után 45 fok az
aszfalt, 06 bára, hogyha
felfújja a gumit.
And off we go for the top four of the line, out of the chicane. Good acceleration for maximum speed from both cars, close together.
Go!
good clean lead car, clean chase car, looks like Rosinger Zsolt managed to pull a little bit of the gap. Like we predicted, huge amount of smoke. There you have it, Ayrton Senna corners disappearing under Achilles tire smoke and Zestino tire smoke at EDC and Hungarian Drift Championship round.
Hölgyeim és uraim, megvárjuk a versenyzőket, amik visszajönnek a rajtra, helyet cserélnek egymással.
The winner of this, we're gonna go to final, and the guy which loses, he will go on the battle for third and fourth place.
Ezen felületi három kamera folyamatosan veszi a képet, és a bírók 5-10 másodperc késéssel viszontlátják ezt a pontozói toronyba. El is indulnak az autók vissza a rajtba.
Grossinger getting a little bit of water sprayed on his intercooler and oil coolers. It's been a really, really hot day here at Hungaroring. Now, as the evening comes, it's not so bad, but it's still really, really hot. So this car's going full lock sideways, not much air coming from the front. Are really, really getting a punishment when it comes to heat.
Ide a büfé felőli oldalra, és nem kell aztán megdobb néznetek.
Here we go, Roman Kolesár leading this time, Grossinger Zsolt giving chase on the S13. There we go, off the line. Zestino tires BMW to the chicane, accelerating down the main straight. Huge entries from both cars, very early initiation. Grossinger Zsolt getting a little bit washed out on the first corner. Then attacking on the second half of the track. And again, it's just so much smoke, so the judges will be able to see exactly what happens on the second half of the track on the live stream camera.
150 és 250 euró között van, akkor kiszámolhatjátok, hogy hány versenyen, vagy bocsánat, egy versenyen hány gumit kell nekik elhasználni.
Really impressive run by Roman Kolesár at the front. This is a very, very close one, as you would expect it from a top four battle. So let's see what the judge is going to decide. Off the line, S13 from Belarus leading. Drift Monkey S15, hot on his heels, very close to initiation, good initiation from both guys. Szabos Szilárd very close, he's getting washed out a little bit towards the outside zone. Really good lead run, really good chase run. Good run from both of the drivers. The lead car, S13 from Belarus, had a good initiation. Szabos Szilárd was really, really fast and really, really close on the first half of the first corner. That he got a little bit offline on the outside, but he still managed to keep the proximity. The lead car also missed the second outside zone. So let's see what the judges have to say about this.
Meg kell várnunk az autókat, amik visszajönnek a rajtba, természetesen ezt a kis türelmet kérjük mindig tőletek, hiszen elég nagy a különbség mind méterben, mind szint különbségben a pálya rajtja és a pálya befejezése között. És itt vagyunk a Senna kanyarban, hogyha valaki még nem tudná.
Let's see if Szabó Szilárd can use his abilities and his car abilities to pull a little bit of the cap on this lead run. We know his car is really fast through transitions, but Dima is also very fast on entries. His driving style is huge angle, huge smoke screen. Off they go, out of the chicane, Szabó Szilárd leading, Dima Nagula on the chase, good initiation from both cars. Great chase from Dima Nagula, really, really great chase. And they spin it around.
Van egy kis technikai probléma, úgy látom, Szabó Szilárd autójával.
I'm pretty sure he should be fine. Was not a major contact. The most important thing is if his front suspension and steering is still working, or if he was damaged in the crash. Apparently, from what we can see from here, from the judges' tower on the track, it looks like he broke a tie rod. Because only one of his wheels is turning, so he's gonna be needed to be towed off.
Pici ideje ahhoz, hogy megjavítsa. So
looks like there's definitely a problem with his front wheels. So let's see what happens in this situation. Yeah, it's confirmed. Szabó Szilárd is guilty for the crash. Dima Nagula takes the win and advances to the final. We'll see if Szabó Szilárd can fix his Drift Monkey S15, because he should be on the battle for the third and fourth place. Zsolt is a veteran. He's been winning lots of rounds on the championship. Roman Kolesár wants to prove his new Zestino tires on the track, so they both won the win very bad. Here we go, off the line, full throttle of the first corner. Good initiation from both guys. Good line at the front. Now Zestino tires, BMW gets washed out pretty bad in the first corner. And I think losing a Zsolt a bit shy from the second outside zone. Let's see how the judge is gonna deliberate this one.
Rosinger Zsoltnál az előny egyértelműen látszott. Nézzük a visszajátszást itt a toronyban, megindítják a srácok, elrakják keresztbe. Viszont Román Kolesár ugyanúgy a teller, mint az előző, nem?
This is a similar situation with the previous run. It seems like whoever initiates first has a little bit of upper hand, and the chase car, it always gets a little bit washed off in the first corner. So let's see how they figure this out and make the strategy for the reverse run. And off we go, off the lines, Zestino tires, BMW to the chicane, Achilles tire S13 chasing down the main straight. Good initiations simultaneously. Very good first corner from both cars. Somebody touched a little bit the dirt. Kolesár was trying to put on the pressure. These guys are going full out. Kolesár was trying to put his fastest lap possible, so he tried to run away. Let's see what the judges are going to decide. And it's official, S13, Achilles tires, using Achilles tires from Hungary goes to the final. Grozinger Zsolt wins this battle and he advances to the final. He's going to be fighting with Dima Nagula. So we have two S13s, very similar setups, crazy power, both of them, wise FAP suspension, fighting for the first place today here at Hungaroring. And we are ready to go. Szabó Szilárd is going to be leading this first run, being qualified number 4, and Roman Kolesár is a Stino Tires BMW chasing qualified number 6. Here we go, off the line, off the chicane. Huge acceleration, tucking in behind Szilárd. Great acceleration from both cars. Szilárd having a great line and good speed at the front. Kolesár chasing very hard. Both guys missed the second outside zone, but other than that, a pretty strong lead run, a pretty strong chase run for both guys.
Hogy lássuk, mi a helyzet, mindenki azt nézi, hogy mi történt a füstben, hiszen abban az esetben is mi szemből látjuk az autókat, hiszen az operatőreink a Red Crab jó voltából a pálya három portjáról filmeznek folyamatosan.
Seems like getting feedback from the judges, Szabó Szilárd has a slight advantage of the front. He managed to pull a gap on the chase car. It's true that he missed the second clipping zone a little bit, but even so he had a really flowing and fast run through the track. He was perfect on the first outside zone, so he has a small advantage going to the second half of this battle. And off we go. Zestino Tires BMW E46 in front, out of the chicane. Drift Monkey S15 chasing hard down the straight line. Close together both guys. You can hear anti-lags going on. Really nice and tight line from the BMW. Szilárd gets a little bit washed out on the first corner, but then he manages to fill up the gap. Touches a little bit of dirt on the second outside point, and then I think something happened. Because he lost drift, can't clearly see because of the smoke, but I'm pretty sure the judges will be able to see it on the live stream camera.
Nos, a pálya hátsó szakaszában Szabó Szilárd ismételten rontott, itt az elejében nagyon lemaradt, és nem a jó ívben haladt, nem tudta követni Roman Kolesárt. Viszont a pálya hátsó szakaszában is volt egy pici hiba, ezt pont most nézzük vissza, hiszen 10 másodperc késéssel halad a videó itt fent a pontozói toronyba. A Szabó Szilárd leszakította az első lökhárítóját, valamilyen oknál fogva ez okozhatta azt, hogy kiegyensúlyozott a pálya hátsó szakaszában. Pici pályakarokban tartás következik.
So it looks like this is a winning formula, because we have in the final two S13 chassis, both with 2GZ engines and rear cooling systems. One from Hungary, one from Belarus. Dima Negula is a good driver. We enjoy watching him at Trackwood as well. And here you have the drivers just saying hello to the fans, showing their appreciation for the support they're getting.
Just a minute, drivers showing, or just a minute to show you for the spectators. So, I feel today here at Hungaroring.
Dima Negula says that he's feeling great here, but it was very hot today, which I totally agree with him. He had a great day. He even crashed the front and rear suspension of his cars on his car, but still managed to fix it. Qualified first, and now he's in the final. What better day than this can you get? So,
after the battle, we are meeting here and we are making the ceremony here, okay?
Gözinger Zsolt, he's all in the game. Multiple wins under his belt, national champion in Hungarian National Drift Championship, I think for a few years. Always a nice, consistent driving style, so I'm pretty sure this battle is going to be intense. This is actually a good way also for the drivers to release a little bit of the pressure of standing on the start line, coming in front of the fans, being cheered up a little bit, and then they have to put the helmets on, focus again, and go hard for the final.
Hát igazából most teljesen elvonatkoztattam, nem tudok beszélni, mert hogy bajnok vagyok. Nagyon ideges hangzik. A lényeg, hogy ezt az versenyt vártam egész évben, és teljesen mindegy, hogy hanyadik lettem volna, vagy bármi lett volna a végkifejlet. Ez a kedvenc pályám közé tartozik.
Szóval Grózinger Zsolti, én sem tudok már beszélni rám is 40 fokon. Tippeld meg hány fokon a kocsitban.
So here we go, Hungary versus Belarus in final. This is Eastern European Drift Championship, Hungarian National Drift Championship from Hungaroring, Ayrton Senna Corners. Great event today, what an awesome day, and this is going to be a great final. Both these guys have intense driving style, and both they drive on full lock with full throttle and huge screen smoke. Huge screens of smoke. And this is what we've been waiting for. The guys been qualifying and during the heat battling all day, and these two end up in the final. We have Dima Nigula front, Grózinger Zsolt the rear, struggling for grip. Crazy initiation from the lead car, good initiation from Grózinger. Unfortunately goes over the white line, two wheels off on his chase car. This is basically handling a huge advantage to Dima Nigula. So it will be really, really difficult for him to recover from this, but let's see the second half of this battle. Dima Nigula had a very, very good pull off the line, even if he went through the chicane. Grózinger Zsolt struggled to keep up with him, making lots of tire smoke, struggling for grip to catch up with him. The graphics, the telemetry from DEMS system shows that Dima Nigula matched his qualification speed of 140 km/h entry speed. And I'm pretty sure Grózinger was trying to keep up with him, and he pushed a little bit too hard, putting two wheels off in the first corner. Ready to send them on the second half of this battle. Off the line, Grózinger Zsolt in front, out of the chicane, trying to get grip. Fast down the straight, huge initiation from both these guys. Good proximity at the rear. Screen smoke is on. Can't really see much what's happening on the second course, second half of the course. But it seems that this was a good run for both of the drivers. Now the judge is going to check exactly what happened on the live stream camera on the section of the track where it's hard to see because of the smoke, and we're going to see who's the winner of the day.
Szóval, hölgyeim és uraim, már is hozok az autókat a díjátadóra, amennyiben van eredmény, és van döntés.
So it seems like the judges have a decision. Now we're going to wait for both cars to come back. They're going to line up right in front of the judges' tower, and we're going to have the prize giving ceremony. Here we have the guys lining up. All three of them deserve their position. They've been driving very well all day. All three veteran drivers, strong drivers. Good to see a mix of nations. So we have Belarus, and we have Slovakia, and we have Hungary on the podium. This is the great thing about events like EEDC. It actually brings together, like I said, different style of drifting from different parts of Europe. So it's actually quite amazing to see three different countries on the top three positions of the podium.
Szóval, hölgyeim és uraim, várjuk a negyedik autót! Várjuk a negyedik autót ide a rajtba, addig a fotósok csinálhatják a képeket. Szóval a fotósok csinálják a képeket.